God, niggas crazy here. Yeah.
I feel like outside in Florida in the midday.
Oh, God.
Exactly. At least Florida got a goddamn breeze. This motherfucker ain't got no breeze.
Yeah, right.
It's crazy. For sure, we got a little breeze.
I live in Florida. I live in Miami.
Oh, yeah, me too, yeah.
Like, on Gucci, I listen to Malcolm. What I listen to, I listen to Nas. I Give You Power, you know, where he talking about the gun. Yeah. Brody, I listen to all the story songs, folks. So I'm like, all right, okay, I know how to come, okay.
That's one of the hardest shit. I ain't gonna lie, that's so crazy on Rock Gray. Nigga, Mick made me listen to that song before I did Malcolm.
I give you power.
What?
Oh, Brody.
Like, coming up, bro. Like, I done watched your videos 100 times of you making beats in 10 minutes and rapping on them bitches, bro. Like, you don't even know, man.
Folks don't want to put the album out, man.
Oh, me?
Yeah, man.
Yeah, not right now.
What you waiting on?
I'm thugging right now.
Some shit with all your rappers.
You know what I'm saying?
Folks know how to rap his ass. Boy, he want to play.
Bro, he just thugging.
Rapping.
Don't let him lie to you about. Come on, he be really rapping, bro.
Thugging, son.
It's true, bro.
Rap rapping.
Got more songs than me. I ain't gonna laugh. No bullshit, this man. Sizzle got more songs than G Herbo.
To any gas station, any liquor store, anywhere, you good. You go to Atlanta, you bound to run into some other niggas who like that. It's a lot of niggas in Atlanta that's gangsters getting money. It ain't like a lot of gangsters out here getting money. They stay in their own zone.
You know the difference is? I know them niggas. Y'all feel like them niggas gangsters. Them niggas don't be gangsters. They just getting money. Don't get that shit fucked up.
Florida's
niggas like Atlanta. Niggas in Atlanta, like, I'm going to tell you, it's two types of niggas in Atlanta. You ain't finna be no killer in Atlanta or no niggas that's killing no killers and getting money. That's don't work like that. Like, I'm from the South Side. We just shoot shit. We don't sell drugs. You feel me? Like, we ain't never been no niggas known to
see. Are you saying like niggas ain't multitasking?
No, bro. Either we gon' you taking hits, nigga, or either your ass getting, or you selling dope. Which one is
that's
it?
That's how that shit is in the Rock.
Yeah, it ain't both. So it's like, you'll see a nigga getting some money, he gon' have some little niggas with him that might be hitting shit.
On, bro, ain't
but lying. He ain't hitting shit. Even when we outside, like, it just be shit like that.
And then in Atlanta, niggas like got a like staring problem. Like in Rock, we don't.
And then Rock, we don't play like that. Like a nigga stare at you, okay, we finna get it on. Like in Atlanta, nigga stare at you until some shit. Like, okay, he forcing your hand with this shit. Like,
I'm sorry to tell you, bro, bitch, you a famous rapper, bro. Everybody gonna stare at you, bro. What the fuck? I be burnt like that too. I be like, man, what them nigga looking at? Why them nigga be like, bro? You who you is, bro? You tripping? Like, bro, why nigga? Why they looking over here? Like, stop looking at me. I hate that.
All right, so leaving the studio now, 5:38 in the morning. Well, we just left the studio. I just dropped off Gabe and Nuri at the hotel, and that's it. I'm going home to sleep because it's 5:30. It's gonna start getting light soon, and probably gonna be some traffic on the way home, maybe. I don't know, so. That's it for tonight, and we're gonna pick this one. This is a good night, actually. The song that they did came out fire, and it's a really good song. It's a really good song. And it was just a good night. I mean, Herb talked a lot tonight, so it was some, you know, he gave us a lot of good stuff, talking about juice and everything like that, so. It was a cool night. I had a lot of fun tonight. So I hope you guys enjoyed, and we'll pick this back up tomorrow. So see you then. So guys, welcome back to the vlog today. So it is like almost, it's like 9:30, 10. I pretty much slept all day because I got in last night from the studio with Herb and Polo and Scheme and Southside and Nuri. I didn't get home till like 6 a.m. So I slept until like 4 and did some shit around the house. I had to upload all that footage and everything. So now I'm up and out. I'm in, where am I? Marina Del Rey area, kinda. Over here to meet up with my friend Matteo, who owns The Rare. So I'm here to pick up some bud for me and actually Scheme too, since he's in town. We're gonna hook him up. So yeah, I'm just in the parking lot right now. Just parked next to this M3. Looking good, right? I don't think I'm parked in the right spot too. I just parked in a space. This is not visitor parking, but who gives a shit? I don't give a shit.
It's just a big ass box like this. Oh my god. Looking for some tree. God damn it. It's a box maziness.
bitch. You just have a fucking lost box of weed over here somewhere.
Literally. Oh. Could be that one.
Hey.
Found it. All right, so I'm leaving Matteo's right now. I'm going to meet up with Scheme, just talk to him. And then also, which I forgot about, Hakeem sent me a flyer, but little TJ is having a album release party tonight. So Scheme, or I just called him, was on his way right there. So I'm gonna go pull up on him there, and then we're gonna take it from there. But I'm gonna get my big camera together, the Sony, the FX3, and use that. Since I'm gonna go to an event, I wanna get better footage than just using this little camera. So we're gonna put that together now, so when I get there, I'm all, just all ready to go, so. All right, so I pulled the camera out, ready to go, and that's it. We're gonna hit the road and head over there, let's go.
I'm at Scheme's Hotel. I'm about to go inside and meet him and Nuri. I talked to Itai tonight, and then one of Itai and I's mutual friend Nico, the one that you saw, I went to his house the other day, is having some sort of party tonight. So I think we're all gonna go pull up on him. So we're going there, meet up with Scheme and Nuri. Itai has been getting ready, so we'll wait to see what he's doing. And then we're gonna see where the night takes us again. So here we go, guys. So
here's the car. It's a Toyota Yaris. Go. Right here. Coming up somewhere.
Looks like the party got shut down before I got here. But we're gonna just scoot up the street and go to Pete's house real quick. So there it is. There's their Uber. All right, let's go.
Hey. Hey, man. We out here, nigga, on some dumb shit.
Yo, you ready to go to another party?
I guess we is. Rockets on the phone. Rockets, say what up to Chris Long Vlog.
Chris Long, what the fuck?
Hey. Come on, follow us.
Because we were like going to that one, the album release party that got shut down. And then we pulled up to Pete's house, but Pete was leaving. We actually saw Pete at the gas station. And then I ran into Chris King there. And then we were going to another party, but on the way there, that party got canceled or whatever. And then we got sent that address, her house. And I wasn't supposed to send the address to, like, the first we were just going to another party and it was no big deal or whatever, and then I wasn't supposed to send that address to Chris King, K Suave. And we got there, it seemed like some of the people in there were giving us a little bit of attention because we showed up with a bunch of people and there wasn't a lot of people at first, but we got in, everything was cool, and it was funny because Quincy walked up to somebody and he's like, the guy was like, or the kid was like, no, we nobody knows who you guys are, so, you know, whatever. And I was like walking in and Quincy was like, we're here with Chris Long. And he's like, oh, all right, why didn't you say so? Yeah, come on in. He didn't know. Oh, yeah, you're good. And I was like, at first I didn't even know who it was. And I was like, what? What's going on right here? Then I realized who it was. I knew the kid. But I was like, who? I'm like, how are they getting in on my name? Like, who do I know? What the fuck? But no, it was cool. I had my camera, but I didn't pull it out and film. I didn't want to. It was like a weird vibe at first. So I just filmed some stuff on my phone. And that's it. Now it is 6:30 in the morning. And I just about to pull into my house. And I was just relaxing. If you hear the music, it's like super like relaxing meditation music that I'm listening to on the drive home to relieve myself from all the fucking weird stress, weird people that you're around at these weird events in LA. But Yeah, that's it. I'm gonna go. I'm gonna sleep for a little while, and then we're gonna be right back at it pretty soon. So let's go. What's up, gang? Welcome back today. So got started a little bit earlier today. It's 4:45 right now, so not bad. I haven't been at it for a little while. I already washed my car. I actually got a new tuner for my car or whatever. Program and change a bunch of fuel maps and stuff like that. So my friend Jerm came over this morning. We installed that. And then went and washed my car and stuff. So now that's installed. So that's crazy. It's running good. I haven't really gotten on it too much, but I can already feel crazy difference just even putting it on the auto fuel map. So I'm gonna go to the gas station that's not too far away from my house and get some 100 octane race fuel and put it in a different fuel map that can handle like the bolt-ons that I have. I have an intake, now I have this JB4 tuner, and then I also have the no cat and a downpipe exhaust. So should be doing pretty good. These cars have like 320 stock, and this JB4 tune is supposedly supposed to add about 80 to 90 horsepower. So that plus the downpipe and intake, you know, should be somewhere around 400 in this thing. I think a little over 400, honestly. But yeah, I'm excited. I got a big front mount intercooler coming too. And then I also have some big sway bars I'm putting in this thing on Thursday. So yeah, I've been doing some stuff to the car. So pretty excited for that. But yeah, I'm gonna go to the gas station and put some race fuel in this thing. And then I'm gonna hit up like Scheme and those guys and see what they're at today.
I'm literally about to FaceTime you. Like, I'm like looking at my phone, like searching your contact. Let's go.
I'm coming. I park in the street.
I look up and you're like there chilling. We're just vibing. You know what I'm saying? At the good old London.
The London. How's it been? What did you do today?
Nothing really. Just vibe. Just woke up. Got dressed. Been chilling,
yeah.
Plotting, me and Scheme just fucking talking shit. Listen to all the records like a million times.
So, you do this. I can talk to you guys in the mirror. So, I was saying this to you last night. Do the most LA shit within here. When you guys are here.
Oh my God.
No, I don't do LA shit on my own, but when they're here, I'm doing LA shit. Like, go to these fucking YouTubers' houses and shit like that. Like,
it's the morning when you grab. This way. Yeah, man. That was a lot.
Yeah.
I was telling Gabe how I was like, yo, I look over at Chris and I'm like, yo, I think I want to be out. And Chris is like, let's leave. And I'm like, dude, I can't, like, I might have FOMO. Like, what if some shit goes down and we miss out? You're like, Nuri, we've been here for, this way. Big Nuri, we've been here for like 2 hours, bro. What has happened? Nothing.
I'm like, shit.
Yeah, because I hate everything and everyone. So,
yeah, same.
You know, I'm pretty good at this.
I do too, but.
I do too, but you're like actually open about it.
What's up, Mr. Gabe?
They look like I have huge lips.
Yeah, what totally. How you doing?
I'm doing good.
How you feeling?
I'm a little tired today.
I mean, yeah, we were out till like 6 a.m. So I was out till 6 a.m.
One thing that you gotta learn when you're with DJ Scheme is that you never leave when you wanna leave, because he is the type of dude that has to change what he's wearing 16 times before we leave the place. He's gotta look good.
We're gonna Nary's closet and get you looking right. Hey, are we leaving? Like right now?
I think so.
Are we grabbing the jacket and we're dipping?
Yeah, we're at Kohl's right on the street.
I don't know.
It's Richard.
Well, I'm gonna jump it.
That's a little tighter than I thought.
Face
really,
it was very expressive. Please.
Oh my god, the Herb.
That's my dog right there. Hey, that's my dog. Disgusting. Disgusting, bro. I can't
hold on. I don't know how deep we can go.
Dang,
we don't really know what we're doing.
That was nice right there. I needed that. Damn, I need a good massage.
Huh?
What's up?
This is a challenge that I'm willing to take.
Come on,
Gabe, shut up.
Why don't you like
Gabe,
him?
Shut up, man.
He's all right. I met him. He's cool.
Is he?
I don't like anyone. So.
Is he a nice guy?
Wow, if Chris, Chris goes, yeah, he was cool. He was just like that. Me. That honestly.
Guy, right?
He's nice to me. Yeah, he's cool.
Is he nicer than me? Look,
nicer
Chris.
Than you.
Look.
That's a weird thing to say because we're close friends. So
no, but look, when someone's nice to Chris, right, and he says that they're nice,
that's kind of weird. To me.
No, it's really good because if Chris doesn't even talk to someone and he doesn't like them, he's gonna be like, yeah, fuck that person. So like, if he actually even got words in, and Chris
maybe
still said
good.
He's okay,
maybe he's just that good at faking
he's
himself.
Valid.
Maybe he's just that good at faking himself.
I mean,
and
some
he made
people
himself
are,
seem really nice to Chris,
that, bro.
I gotta meet this guy. When I meet him, I'll be like, yo, bro, I can't front. I think you're a pussy, so you gotta show me otherwise.
Yeah. What if he just slits you right in your shit right then and there?
You know what I'd do? I'd go up to him and I'd be like, nah, that was some hard bitch ass nigga. Don't ever do that shit.
Yeah,
but you gangster for punching me. You gangster for punching me.
What if he just slaps you in the face?
He slaps me? You know what I'd do? I'd spit in his face and fuck him up. If I get slapped publicly, I'm spitting in his face.
Let's be realistic about what's gonna happen.
Okay, I'll give him a hug. No. We hug. How about we both hug it out?
I air that place out if you get hit.
All right, so we're leaving Cole's spot, and then we're going to go to where we were at last night. So I'm not sure I'm going to be able to bring the camera in there, but I'll record some shit on my phone again. So we're going to go pop over there now and see what's good. So let's go.
Sir. All right, guys.
What's up?
Yo, guys, so that's it. We went to go play. Got some iPhone clips.
Hey.
Now we're with the gang.
Yes, sir. We in this bitch, man.
We're at the hotel. Outside.
Yeah, we are.
Just smoking a little bit.
The night's fucking over.
Night's over. It's like 5 in the morning, 5:30 in the morning.
I got a couple interviews.
All right, guys. So I'm going to wrap the vlog up here. It's Sunday night. I haven't done anything today. I'm going to go out now. I'm going to go drop this footage off to Ben and get him working on this so I can drop the vlog this week. And I might go meet up with Scheme and stuff. But if I vlog, I'm going to start it on the next vlog. So I want to thank you guys for watching. Do me a favor and like this video, share this video, subscribe to my channel, leave a comment. I'll see you soon.